Hello, class. This is Dr. York-Hammons again. I had a little bit of time at the conference to work a couple of problems from Chapter 4, Sections 2 and 3. I'm actually looking at the homework question that some of you might have seen. It says 69% of men consider themselves professional baseball fans. You randomly select 10 men and ask each if he considers himself a professional basketball fan, and then find the probability that the number who consider themselves baseball fans is, for part A, exactly 5. Now, if you go to question help, they are going to have you do a combination and powers of P and Q. If you use StatCrunch, all you need to know is N and P. In this case, you randomly select 10 men, so that's your value for N. N is 10. And from previous results, they found that 69% is our probability, so that would be 0.69 as a probability. So if you go to StatCrunch and you go to Stat, there are calculators, and we want the binomial calculator because this is a binomial probability distribution. Now, when you do that, another screen pops up, and if you've used it before, there are probably other values of n and p that are listed. In this case, our problem, n is 10, and p is the 0.69 from the 69%. And I want exactly 5. So in my drop-down list, I pick the equal sign. And exactly 5. And compute, it usually goes blank once you start changing the numbers down here for the probability, whatever you want for X. And it says that the probability is 0.11283776. And then you see a red bar that indicates that's the only probability that you're looking at. But they want us to round it to 3 decimal places. So that would, if it's 3 decimal places, that would be the 112. I look to the right as an 8, so that's going to make that a 0.113. Then it wants the probability that X is greater than or equal to 6. So I'm still using the same N and P values. I simply need to change my inequality to greater than or equal to, and my number from 5 to 6, and compute. And it shows you that you're adding the probabilities for 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 all together to get 0.83205254. But rounding that to 3 decimal places would be 0.832. And then the last one is x less than 4, which would be the values 3, 2, 0, or 3, 2, 1, and 0. So let's see if we can do less than 4 and compute. And you see a 3 and you see a 2, and then you don't see anything for 0 or 1. And what that means is that those probabilities are so small that they can't graph them. But if you were to add them all together, you would get 0.012, and then there's an 8. So that 2 is going to become a 3, 0.013. Point 0.013. Now, that went ahead and went to another question. I wanted to come back over here and talk to you for just a minute that if I did exactly 1, because we talked about that number might be really small. Can you see that the probability of exactly one man is 0.00018? It's so tiny, there's no way they can get it on this binomial calculator graph, but they can give you a numerical value. So the next problem that came up is pretty much the same as that one. Let's move to another one and see if we can get one. So I paused for just a second so I could find a problem that asked you to find a probability between two numbers. So we're going to start with, it says 26% of college students say they use credit cards because of the rewards program. You randomly select 10 college students. That's your value for N. It's still 10. And ask each to name the reason he or she uses credit cards. Find the probability that the number of college students who say they use credit cards because of the rewards program is exactly 2, is our first problem. Now, based on prior surveys, 26% of college students say they use credit cards because of the rewards program. So our p-value is 0.26. So when I come back over here to StatCrunch, my n is still 10. My p-value is 0.26. And I want exactly two students saying that they chose it for the rewards. You see there's just one red line at 2, and that is 0.2735 or 0.274 to the nearest thousandth, or the third decimal place, 0.274. So that's very similar to what you just did before. P of x greater than 2. So I have to, I'm using the same value for N and P, but I do greater than 2. And you have to click compute so it changes the number. And you see greater than 2 would include 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Again, the numbers get really small the higher we go, so you don't see them in the graph, but they've been included in that total, 0.504. Now the last question asks you to find the probability that x is between 2 and 5 inclusive. That means that you're going to include the values of 2 and 5. Now the only thing you need to change in StatCrunch is to use the between and then type the two numbers. So that would be between 2 and 5, and if you click compute, it says between 2 and 5 is 0.7538 or 0.754. And then that gets us to a different problem. But you're more than welcome to use the binomial calculator to calculate those values for P. I realize that there's nothing showing here on StatCrunch to show that you've done that work, even if you close it and it shows that one result. It's only going to show that one binomial calculator for the most recent problem. And so you'd want to be sure that you worked your problems in separate StatCrunch sessions, so I would at least see that calculator for the problem. Thank you for your time, and I hope that this helps you with Chapter 4.